was hoping it wasn't going to be raining when I am trying to upload this content today, but we never know in Disney Dreamlight Valley. We just never know when it's going to be rainy, and that is the case right now as soon as I jumped on. If you are new here, hi, I'm Chazzles Renee, and thank you so much for joining me today. If you are one of my lovely returning subscribers, hi, my loves. I hope you're all doing well on this Monday. Oh God, turtles, what are you doing? So if you haven't noticed already, I have the cute little Ariel joining us today, and that is because we got some pretty exciting news from Disney Dreamlight Valley saying that in the next update, we could potentially be able to share our Touch of Magic designs. And I am so happy about it because it is my number one thing to do on my channel is to create beautiful dresses using the Touch of Magic tool in, of course, Disney Dreamlight Valley. So I really hope that this is going to be true, and with next update we will get the ability to. So I thought, you know what, I have not done a Tom dress in quite some time just because I've been busy with Stardew Valley among other things. And I thought, you know, since we got this news, let's make a dress today for my content. So we are going to be making Ariel her cute little elegant pink dinner dress that she wears in the movie. Whoa, that was like a weird effect with the clouds. I don't know if you guys seen that in the back, but that was interesting. But anyways, that is what I'm going to be doing today. I'm going to be making her pink dinner dress inspired by the movie. It's not going to be exactly the same because it's going to be pretty hard to try to make it exactly like her dress, but I'm going to kind of do my own thing and create my own version of it. So if you love Ariel and if you love Touch of Magic design content, then you have come to the right place, and I'm happy to have you here, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. So the dress that I decided to use to create Ariel's elegant dinner dress is the basic long sleeved gown, and I chose this dress because her original one is long sleeved and then it has the puff shoulders at the top, and I just thought this would work the best. I went ahead and changed the default color to the pink that I thought fit the original style of her dress. So Ariel's dress, it kind of drapes down a little bit towards her chest area, and then it also looks like it comes a little off the shoulder. So to create this illusion, I went ahead and grabbed that semi-circle fabric piece, changed it to the flesh color that best matched her skin tone, and then I just went ahead and placed that right above her chest, a little bit below her chin, and then this created the effect like her dress was draping down and also like it was coming off of her shoulders. I then went ahead and did the same thing to her back area. I did not know how difficult it was going to be to make this dress. This is probably one of the most difficult dresses that I have made aside from the Snow White princess gown, but yes, it was quite some work to do. So Ariel's dress has some really puffed up sleeves, and then they also have this white like raindrop pattern that goes around them, kind of similar to the red ones that Snow White has on her dress. So to create the puffed out sleeves with the details on it, I took one of those semi-circle pieces again, added those onto her shoulder, and then I just took the raindrops from the raindrop motif, shrunk it down as small as I could, and then just placed two of them on each sleeve. So Ariel's dress has a lot of detail on it. One of the details is the border that starts from her collarbone and it goes all the way around to her back. In her original dress, it is white, and I wanted to do the same thing for this dress. So I went ahead and used the straight line fabric piece, shrunk it down as small as I could, and then just placed that all around her collarbone all the way to her back. I kind of wish that it shrunk down a lot smaller because it was still a little big for my liking. So probably the most difficult part of this dress was making that effect of that little bit of the white slip showing from underneath her dress. So to create this effect, I had to take one of those square pieces of fabric, blow it up as big as I could get it, and then place that at the top part of the base of her dress, and then I placed another one at the bottom. Thank you. To create the layered effect on her dress, I took the semi-circles once again, but this time I changed the color to the same pink as the base of her dress, and then I just put one on each side of the bottom of her dress. The semi-circles definitely needed some length. Ariel's were a lot more longer than the ones that I had placed down. So to create this effect, I grabbed the oval shape fabric and then I again changed it to that pink base color. And then I applied those right below the semicircle shape. I then went ahead and did the same thing to the back of the dress, and then there was a little bit of white fabric showing, and I just went ahead and covered that up with a square to make sure that it was all covered. So I kept adding the pink oval pieces in the back of the dress just so everything lined up and matched together. And then for the very last piece of Ariel's dress, she does have a little detail on her waist area. I was limited to fabric pieces, so I knew that I couldn't use more than two pieces. So I was kind of on the fence with what detail I was going to use, but I thought, hey, you know what? Those bubbled gems motif would fit so well with her dress. So I just went ahead and kind of made them become a belt, and I just joined two of them together, and that was the waist piece and the final piece on this dress for Ariel. And there we have it, guys. This concludes Ariel's elegant dinner style dress, the infamous pink beautiful ball gown. I am not in love with the way that it turned out, again, because it was so difficult to make. I wish I had a lot more fabric pieces, and I also wish that you can shrink down those motifs and pieces a little smaller than what they give you. But working with everything that I had, I do think that I did my best trying to recreate this dress. And I really think that Eric and Ariel enjoyed it, and that's all that matters. But thank you so much for being here and joining me on this touch of magic design. And if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And please consider subscribing, because there's going to be a lot more touch of magic dress creations in the future. And you don't want to miss out, because now that we have the ability to share our custom designs with other players, you will definitely want to see the dresses I create, and I would be more than happy to share with you guys whichever custom you enjoy the most. Thank you so much, my loves. Until the next one, have a great Monday.